Welcome to Bath Talks with Jim Bruce.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Bath Talks. Assalamu alaikum. Shabbat shalom. I hope I'm pronouncing the first one, Assalamu alaikum, correctly. And if I am, please forgive me. What that is a Muslim greeting. You're probably familiar with it. Peace be unto you. More or less is what it means. Shabbat shalom is a Jewish expression. We say it on the Sabbath, which basically means have a peaceful Sabbath. There's have a peaceful day. There's a lot of other different connotations to the phrase, but fundamentally what you're wishing for the person you're talking to is a good day, good peace, prosperity, goodness, calm that day. I was thinking about those two phrases from those two cultures and what that was. And you know what that is? That's codified decency. Codified decency. I want you to think about that idea of codified decency and the different places we encounter it in our culture. Codified decency is where we decided, man, we need to make sure we're nice to each other, so let's make it official. This is one official way that we're nice to each other. Christmas is another example. Christmas is a holiday in the Christian religion where we express this idea of peace on earth, goodwill towards man. Beautiful. And it's codified. So we have prayers that you say all the time. There's songs that people sing all the time. There's rituals. You give away gifts. You put up decorations. All that are designed to codify decency, to say, this is now in a bedrock part of our culture. Because I think that we all fundamentally realize that unless we do that, we can't always count on each other to be decent on our own. That we have to be encouraged to move towards decency. And I do believe that. And I don't believe that in a negative sense. I don't believe that in a sense of like, man, people are bad. I just believe it in a sense that people left to their own devices are going to tip one way or the other, and you don't want to just leave it up to chance. So societal norms are built up that push you towards kindness, that push you towards decency. And conversely, there are some ugly traditions that push you towards excessive jingoism, that push you towards excessive isolationism. And even within religious expressions, peace be unto you, I mean, Shabbat shalom, you typically say that one Jew to another. You don't typically say that to a non-Jew. And assalamu alaikum, you're saying that to another Muslim. You're not necessarily saying it to everybody. And Merry Christmas, you're not saying that to everybody. So there is a flip side to the coin, which is the isolationism of peace be unto you, if you agree with me. So I'm certainly not saying it's a perfect system, but I'm coming to appreciate the idea that we codify kindness. And I was thinking that maybe you could do that in your own life. Maybe you could, as an individual, codify actions and say, every day I'm going to do this specific kind thing. Not just every day I'm going to be kind, but if you said to yourself, every single day, as a rule, if I go into a restaurant, I'm going to greet the bar staff, or I'm going to greet the cook if I get an opportunity, and thank him. If every single day you were just like, okay, a rule for me personally is when I'm in this situation, I'm always nice. Or if I go to the post office, I don't care how long the line is, that's an unpleasant job, so I'm going to make a point of being nice to the teller. I'm going to make a point of saying, thanks man, I really appreciate it, and I'm going to codify that action. So that even if I'm having a bad day, by ritual, I will always be nice to that person. Because I think fundamentally that's what religion tries to do. And maybe if you were to extract the religion from it, but leave the codification of kindness, we could like pass on little behaviors like that. One of my favorite examples is tipping. Tipping is codifying kindness. So you're not required by law to tip your waitstaff. As long as you pay for your food, you get your food. And if you don't leave a tip, you've done nothing wrong under the law. If you don't pay your bill, you've done something wrong. So a tip is different. A tip is your gratitude for the service, right? And it's so codified that if a waiter or waitress gets a 50% tip, they don't necessarily thank you because that's expected. And you really have to go above and beyond to get the thanks, right? But that's an example. Every single day you can find examples where we codify that kind of thing. And I'd also like to flip it and talk about accepting kindness and accepting gratitude. And I'll give you this example. I worked at this place where every now and then I would help an old person to their car, and the old person sometimes would tip me. And sometimes this happened on a regular basis. If it was an old woman, they would often tip me, and I mean really old, like in their 80s, they would often tip me 2 quarters. That's a real thing, where they would give me 2 quarters. And I made a point of going, thank you. I was always just, thank you so much. And I wasn't being sarcastic, because I knew as far as they were concerned, hey, that's 2 quarters I didn't have before. Now, some of my coworkers, on principle, wouldn't accept tips. They would say, oh, no, thank you. I don't need a tip. I really appreciate that. But I realized one day that not accepting a tip is really a jerk move. I know you think you're doing a good thing. When somebody offers you a tip for something where you're not typically tipped and you don't accept it, you think you're being good because you think, no, 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 I don't need the tip. Accept the tip. You're not accepting the tip for you. You're accepting the tip for them. Because one of the most generous things you can also do is let somebody else be generous. Let somebody else have that good feeling. You know, when you're out to lunch with somebody and they offer to pay and you're uncomfortable because you don't want somebody else to pay for your lunch, let them pay for your lunch. They feel good about that. One of the kindnesses that we can extend to each other is accepting each other's kindness. That's a hard lesson to learn, but it's 100% true. So if somebody says, can I do something for you? You're sick. Can I bring you some soup? You don't need soup. Let them bring you some soup. You'll enjoy the soup, or you won't, but they'll feel good that they helped you out. So, here's your homework for this week. Codify kindness. Think of something that you can add to your life where every day, by consistent ritual, you are kind. And when somebody else tries to be kind to you, be kind in return by accepting their kindness. And take a bath. It's nice.
Bath Talks is a Jim Bruce production. Bubbles provided by Amori Arce. If you enjoyed Bath Talks, click subscribe.